Hello friends. Welcome to the 34th episode of Hashtag Backlinks. In the last video I taught you to create 5 contextual backlinks on 75 plus domain authority websites. In today's video I will teach you to create 5 profile backlinks on 90 plus domain authority websites, and in the tips and tricks section, I will tell you about the domain ranking factors. If you want to learn off-page SEO strategies or want to get your website ranked, you can avail my 120 days of daily link building guide subscription. You can apply the action plan given in the guide for all the languages and niches. With the help of this guide, users are getting their website ranked and driving organic traffic to their website. Now, let's go ahead and start today's topic. Our first website for today's episode is Firefox. Here, after creating the account, when you log in, you have to place your URL in the homepage field of the profile section. Your backlink will be ready as soon as you click on Create My Profile button, which you can check by clicking on View My Profile. Our second website is active. After creating an account here, when you log in, you have to go to the settings. Scrolling down, you will see the blog field, where you can place your URL. By clicking on the submit button, your backlink will be ready, which you can check by going to your profile page. Our third website is Jiffycat. After registering here, when we log in, we have to go to the settings. There you have to place your URL in the Your Website field. By clicking on Save Changes, your backlink will be ready, which you can check by going to your profile. Our fourth website is Microsoft. Here, after creating an account, when you log in, click on your username above. You will be redirected to your profile page, where you have to click on Edit My Profile button. There you have to place your URL in the website field. By clicking on the Save button, your backlink will be ready, which you can check by going to your profile. Last but not the least, our fifth website is zippyshare. Here, after creating an account, when you log in, you have to go to My Account. On the left-hand side, you will see the option of Account Settings, by clicking on which, you can place your URL in the Personal Website Link field. Your backlink will be ready as soon as you click on the Save Settings button, which you can check by going to your profile. In today's tips and tricks section, we will talk about domain ranking factors. As you can see, Google has mentioned in its patents that Google will use some signals to distinguish between legitimate and illegitimate domains. One of them is domain registration length. Google says that you can register a domain for a maximum period of 10 years, and those who are legitimate websites register or renew their domain for a longer period. And Google believes that people who register or renew their domain for 1 year generally use it as temporary or throwaway domains to deceive search engines so that they can drive maximum traffic before being caught. So keep your domain registration length for more than 1 year, as Google considers it as ranking factor. As an example, you can see, I have renewed my domain for 2 years. Similarly, in Whois you can find the registration length of any domain. Your domain history is also a ranking factor. If you have purchased an expired domain and that domain has a spammy history or a spammy backlink profile, then you will be sweating to rank it. If a domain is penalized, its penalty can be carried forward to the new owner as well. Therefore, before buying any domain, make sure to check the domain in archive.org. If there is any activity showing in it before you acquired it, then make sure to check its content to find out if the content is spammy, and at the same time, check the quality of its backlink profile. You can use Arifs or SEMrush to check its backlink profile. If your domain has a country-specific, top-level domain, then it indicates your target country. Suppose your TLD is .in, and then it means that you are indicating to Google that your domain and its content is suitable for Indian traffic. But, this does not mean that the domain will rank easily in India. .com TLD will also rank as easily as it will rank .in TLD. Today's episode has an interesting question for you. If you write Spanish content on a French TLD, where will your content rank? Spain, France, or it won't rank anywhere? Do post your answer in the comment box below. There was a time when EMD or exact match domains were very much in craze, as these domains would rank very easily without backlinks, even if it was a low quality content website. But now it is not the case. As you can see, I searched for best hotels on Google and got many results, but besthotels.com is not showing anywhere in the first page. Let's take another example of besthosting.com. If you search for best hosting on Google, then it will also not appear on the first page. Google's EMD update in September 2012 has put limitations on the benefits which low-quality content websites were enjoying from exact match domain. EMD websites get some positive ranking factors, but for that you have to create high-quality content website. If you have a parked domain, then Google is removing it from its index. Google has clearly mentioned in its official blog that it does not consider parked domains as good, so actively de-indexing them. That's all for today. I hope you must have learned a lot from today's video. You can post your doubts, demands, and suggestions in the comment box below, or you can ask in the WhatsApp group or Telegram channel of #backlinks. Let's meet in the next video, with something informative and something very interesting.